Oh yes, good morning, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, my brothers and sisters. I know I have brothers and followers in America. I have friends in Canada. I have my village brothers and sisters in Bumachoge, Burabu constituents. I have my friends in Kisii, I have my friends in Nairobi. And wherever you are, I want to say hi and good morning and good afternoon and good evening. Now, I have never done this, but this morning I have been triggered, or rather been pushed, to talk about something. Kidogo tu. And actually, I woke up, mimi nikakuja into my study room, I preparing for my exams this evening. And actually, if you are a person, if you love, you know, reading books on international economics, on international politics, kama unapenda books on about, of course, about love, about, you know, family and the like, you can talk to me nicely and get you 1 or 2 or 3 books. I have quite a collection here now. That is not the reason why I decided to do this video. Sasa, mimi nimetulia, nasoma, najaribu ku Google, najaribu ku understand a few concepts on international relations, and then a message pops into my phone. It's a WhatsApp message, and of course, from, you know, my better half, my wife, who had just stepped out to go to work. And then, mimi nafungua, it's a photo. I thought maybe, she normally likes sending memes to me and then complains why I don't laugh. Sometimes those memes are not funny. Either, it ought to be a meme or a very old photo of me that maybe she found somewhere in social media or somewhere and then she wants to laugh or mock me. Or, it's a budget. Number one, number two, number three, you know, tissues, potatoes, total 4,500, mostly sometimes, you know, 6,200. Napenda kuchezea hapo. I thought maybe it's either one of those, you know, the things I'm used to, but then I realized it was a totally different thing. I opened the photo and then I saw my handwriting. I was like, okay, definitely this must be something maybe I wrote. Good or bad? Ama labda ni ule wakati wa zile enzi za kitambo. Maybe you were writing something about your girlfriend or writing something about your mom or somebody. Hey, Buddha. She had my diary. And this was a 2016 diary. I had written about my ambitions. I had written about, you know, what I wanted to be. At that particular moment, I was old, 25 years, and I wanted to become a member of parliament to Bumachoge Burabu constituents. So I was putting down my strategies. Whom will I approach? How will I raise my, you know, campaign resources? And they like, name them. So these were names. I had written, you know, the title, The Persons I'll Buy Suits For Every Month When I Become an MP. I can't say, kino kino roka MP. Now, number one, let me mention them. Number one, Principal Anton Nyatundo, my father, all right? My father from Bonchari constituents, a very close friend of mine. You know, the only man who calls me and tells me, stop that nonsense. And I listen. And the way he talks to me, you know, brings back life, brings me back to life whenever I'm down, whenever I'm hurt. I think I was right to have you as my number one person that I was to buy suits for every month. Dad, tokumina babi korala. Number two, was this Zablon Ongori. Who actually became my dad. You know, from the village. You know, I don't have a dad, I don't have a mother. So these are my dads. You know, these are my dad. The people took over the shoes of my father. Zablon Ongori, from my village. He's actually, now he's a chief officer in the county government of Kisii. He used to be. He was there, number two. Number three, I had my own reasons why. You know, I had to arrange them in that order. Number three was Honorable Birundu. Birundu was actually a running mate of our Wiper gubernatorial candidate in Kisii. And you know, there's a way he could bring us, you know, together. Myself and Andrew Maubi, my brother from Kitutu Church South. Thank you very much, bro, for some of the things we used to go through when we were running for this thing. There was Laban Chwea and there was Zahir Janda. Birundu had a way of playing with us. He knew guys who were in this Wiper ticket that actually could make sense. And out of these four, at least he knew one or two. You know, could make it. And he knew we were not so well endowed, you know, financially. And there's a way he could, could manage us, could tell us, you know, if this seems, hey, that's Lumumba now, the gubernatorial candidate. They were not very good buddies. You know, Lumumba was, I would not describe him, so much, but he was a cunning, kind of shrewd, you know, candidate that we had. Alikuwa ana tuleta tukijichoch, you know, we could imagine that a person running for a governor maybe had a budget of around 50 or 100 million. So, lazima kuwe na ka 10 million ka, you know, my MP wake. Those are the things we used to, you know, to imagine. But tukienda kwake hivi tumejichocha, he could tell us, actually you people, munanisikia. You need me more than I need you. Unachua mimi ni mtu ninafanya biashara across the county. Mimi niko na connections. Hata kule kwenu, echate. Mimi, I can tell people to vote for you or not to vote for you. Tunanyamaza. Sisi tumeenda, tunafikiria, tutambongeshe, tupate ka 200 or 100,000. Ka kuingia grau. Buda. Tuliuma inje. And that led to the other developments. You know, now of us deciding to actually, we never supported his candidature. And I'm sorry about that. If you get to see this video, I'm being honest. You know, the guys there, myself, Maobi and the like, we changed our mind and we decided a different person. That was Governor Ongwae. Because you didn't appear to be interested to work with us. And actually, that is politics. Sasa number four kwa hiyo list, to the learner story, yenye, wife amenitumia, of course, was, you know, Lumumba, the guy I've just talked about. And the interest was, kuwapelekea suti, you know, to a nice, personally, sorry, new nice. Ndiyo unelewa vile, you know, the way you can lure, you know, somebody into your side. Upate kakitu. Boss, I think there's something about the mind. What the mind conceptualizes. And then, you know, communicates with the heart. And then it becomes some sort of an intuition. The way you plan your things, the people you give priority in life, actually, a reflection is seen, either thereafter or even in the process. the way I arranged these guys, just the way my wife sent them to me. Na amenitumia kicheka akisema, akiniuliza, how many suits did you buy? None. Because sometimes, you know, we have good plans in life. You plan too many good things. I find some of the boys, you know, 1, 2, 3, you know, anasema, oh, if I was here, I could have done this. If I was flani, I could have done that. Let me tell you, sometimes, you know, life is something. Life is a nut that you must keep on, you know, cracking every day. Unakonga every day to get to understand it, to get to understand it. We live in a community. We live in a world that has people. Sometimes you think these people are there for you. You plan good things. You know, you think about them so nicely. And at the end of the day, you get to realize that out of the entire team of 10, maybe 1 or 2 actually think of the similar thing about you. Now, wacha niwaambie, ilikuwa ile siku ya mwisho, a day to elections. I only had with me, tumepiga campaign, you know, 3 months consecutively, nimeleta, you know, my party leader, Kalonzo Grau, tumetesa, tumezunguka na chopa, tumefanya nini. Now the hype iko pale juu. And there's something about somebody sat us down. Who was this? Zahir. Zahir, akatuambia mazuri na jua say, mnaweza kuwa mmepiga, mmezunguka sana, but finishing power ni muhimu sana. Mnanisikiza? Finishing power, bro, ni muhimu sana. Lazima ukuwe na kitu kama mita moja hivi na nusu, eh? Ya kutesa, uingie ground, nini, watu wasikie ulienda kijiji fulani, ukasera watu, you know, thao, nini. Buna hiyo time mimi niko na 110,000 kwa account. Nafikiria hii jioni, we organized something. I was part of the architects. Now that we had decided we are supporting the candidature of Governor Ngwai and DG Mangi and Sam Ongeri, you know, that entire team of ODM, because actually we were in Wiper. So tukaitwa jioni, tukaenda kwa mheshimiwa Birundu, tuko mimi Chwea from Nyaribari Masaba, Andrew Maubi, Zahir. Hapo ndio Zahir sasa anatuchocha hapo nje, finishing power. Kwa do buda mi sinaeni. So I was like, tukifika huko, definitely. Kwanza vile, you know, deputy governor wetu in our party, that is mheshimiwa Birundu, vile ameamua, he's not going to, you know, he's not so serious about, you know, us winning as Wiper. Lazima kuna doo fulani alikuwa amepanga, alikuwa amepangia ya campaign. Atatusort, atatupea kiasi hivi, hata mita nini. Ama ikiwa mbaya, 500k, tuingie grau, tupige, tutese na tushinde kura. Wah! Tukapanda upstairs. Eh? Kwa room yake akatuambia, sasa, you know, my sons, I wish you well. Na nataka sasa ndio muende mwingie, you know, kijijini kabisa. Elections ni kesho. Mnanisikia? Na mimi vile naona, nyinyi wote mumeenda parliament. Okay. Akaingia hivi kwa rumu, akakuja na thao kumi. 10,000 Kenya shillings. papaso. Budget ni ngapi? 1 million. Ikiwa mbaya 500k. Nilishika kichwa. Nikatembea tembea kwa room. Kafika kwa mlango. Nikarudi. I pick my phone. Nikapigia. Who's that? Rama. I called Ramadan. You know, my boys in my team. Wenye tulikuwa tunazunguka nao. And, you know, they were waiting for me out of the gate. Kamwambia, bro. Hiyo gari iko na mafuta. Eh. Iwashe tuende. So nimetoka hapo nini? Of course, no. I want to thank you, Honorable Birundu. No, not every politician, you know, gives somebody, you know, financial assistance. Many talk big, men do what. But ata ile kidogo, I sincerely appreciate. Now, tukaingia grau, kufika home, kuzunguka sasa, you know, final touches. I met with my wife. I think he alikuwa message akaona hii kitu tunaweza lose. You know, she told me, babe, uko na do ngapi? Babe, tumespend do imeisha. Mi niko na 100,000. Kaniambia nipe hiyo do. Nikampea. I don't know where they went with my, you know, other very, you know, close supporter who got married. And the things changed. Katoka grau. Her name is Maureen. They went to wakarudi na chimbunche, you know, lose. And then she told me, go this direction and go this direction. And that night we moved, I remember, around with my other brother, Abel Mainga, who was my chief advisor from the village. Tukazunguka usiku nini, we did our best. Now, let me go back to the canoe, you know, the kafuto that my wife sent me this morning. Ninyi wazee wenye niliandika kwa ile diary, it is still with me. I want to promise you one thing, or I want to tell you one thing. I have not forgotten about you. And I'm still the very itcher that thought about you. I will fulfill my promise in due course. I'll fulfill what I wrote in due course. God bless you. And thank you, babe, for reminding me this. Goodbye and good day.